Hello everyone, I'm back today. This is the farm area that I already showed you. I'm sorry I've been a little late. I had some school that I had to do. School just started up for me, so that is why. So I'm going to show you another part of my world. Hopefully I'm going to finish off the world, but if not, then there will be a third video concluding this. So this is originally where that little village was that I showed you. This pathway goes there. I had a creeper blast here. So I leveled the village. It was right here. I added this pathway so I could walk easily from the farm to this area. Now this was the first area I built, so the building is not that great. This has what I believe to be my worst build. Remember this? I believe we should be able to come back to it, but it's like the rest of the buildings, but it's kind of broken down. So you go up this bridge, and then you come down. This is the top village. Well, not top, I just named it that. That's not its actual name. This is the first one. This is the compound. Let's do that one first. So, like I said, it was my first building, so it's kind of like not great. I do like using cobble. I don't think it was necessarily a mistake. It's kind of flat. There's not a lot of define. But villagers are in here, and then I stick them in minecarts and see if I want to keep them or not, and they come down here, and the librarians I put down there. I'll tell you why later in the video. We will get to that. And then if I ever wanted to move them, I could switch this lever, and they'd come up this, and I have this little track, and it kind of curves around, but pretty much what it does is it goes out the front here, and then I could shuttle them off to wherever I wanted to bring them. So that's the collecting area. This is just a pretend control station or something. I also can put my horses in here when I come in. Stairs to get out are in the door. The door used to be around front. Well, there, I guess there's still one there. But I used to have to walk all the way around, so I would just jump out like that. So that's this room. I have cake here because it cushions my, doesn't cushion my fall, but because it's a slab, I don't take damage when I land on it. Versus if this wasn't here and I just landed on this, I would take damage. Because I am in UHC, not UHC, but I mean, I'm in no regen mode, so I prefer not to take damage. This was my mass storage before my other mass storage that I'm not sure if we'll get to. But I can put like andesite, but it wouldn't fit in here now, how much I have. But that was originally what that was. Here was my original storage. My original made storage, ender chest. So I had have food, wood. This includes any projects when I divide things up. So things like minecarts, hoppers really shouldn't go in there. They should go in redstone. But like rails, I just went and I got some prismarine, that kind of stuff. Slabs, and stairs, blocks. This is kind of like random blocks. Again, I just went out. Not like stone, but like cacti and that kind of thing. This is decoration blocks, so like glowstone, bookshelves, wool, snow, not necessarily wool that goes in the animal, but like carpets. Tools, these aren't very good tools, those are kind of just my starter stuff. Yeah. Mostly stuff I get from trading and fishing. Ores, kills, anything that I get when I kill something pretty much. Plants and crops, all kinds of plants and crops. Redstone. And then these two chests are actually empty if I ever need more storage. I think I cleared that out. I had books in my one point. These are my emerald supply. Some stuff that I can give to the villagers. And stuff that I've gotten back from the villagers that I haven't gotten around to sorting yet. So, well, I'll show this up here. There is a walkway. Pretty simple. It goes across. This is the actual breeding station. There's two villagers in here, hopefully. Bread falls down. They breed. Babies get pushed down here, and then they stand on that hopper until they're ready to grow up, and then they're too high and they float up the ladder. This is just to catch any bread that those two don't eat. Sometimes if I put a lot through, they don't eat it all. So I have that. Ladder just to get up. So then they would be shuttled up this, pulled across and dropped into there. It's kind of fun to watch. I've only seen it done like once or twice. I used to have just a villager in here. He'd pick food and throw it down there, but it was just a little too hard. It wasn't always working. So I got rid of him and just manually put bread in. I have enough to do that. This is the dispenser. It's an auto dispenser, so if I stick like steak in there, it shoots out automatically. So I can put, as long as it's not like full, some stuff happens and gets stuck. This is a pretty bad build, it's not my worst build, because at least it looks half decent from the outside, but this is a pretty bad build, I will warn you. It's like a office room with some furnaces. Yeah, pretty bad. This is the apartment. So everybody that lived here would work here. I would pressure plate on this one just because I use this bed to sleep, so I'd sleep, pop out, and I'd be able to walk out quicker. Not much, but it did seem to make a difference. Same thing up here. This door, I think, broke. That's why it's a different color or something. Maybe the door broke, I forget. Yeah, I think it'd be that one, I think, downstairs. Yeah, downstairs, there, Birch. Oh, and there's a little view, kind of odd window, little view of a wall. Very interesting. Not really. So then out front, this is where the door used to be, but I changed it. So nothing out there, at least not yet. Pretty simple. Every now and then I get an iron golem or something walking around here. All lit up so that nothing get in here. And our chest to catch any bread. The walls keep zombies out. Pretty good. So I have this river. It does not connect to the main river that I would like everything to connect to. But I put it in here anyway. I think it was a little pond here, and I connected it up to, there was a small like cave that I dug out, and then I made the pond bigger. But I'll show that later. I like to do this. It makes it kind of look like it's dumping sewage or chemicals or whatever. It looks a little more factory-like in my mind. It's kind of cool. We'll do this side of the river, and then we'll wrap around. So this was one of the first builds. It's an auto smelting farm. So, not farm, but... I would put stuff in here. I don't have anything that smelts up, but it would go into the furnace, and then it would come in down here. I actually wouldn't go into these furnaces. These are just for show, or if I wanted to smelt something manually. You can't see what I have in there. So back here, it comes out of here, it gets stuck in the furnace, and there's coal back here. This is the one I mainly use, so I have the most in there. I don't know, I should probably start using this one. Looks like it's quite a bit. Pretty nice. If I ever didn't want something, like if I had garbage, I could just toss it down there and it would get swept out with everything else. I think it's pretty cool. There are some plants in here from when I was first starting. That's where I'd keep like my axes and such. So then we're going to move on to this house. If I have empty water bottles, so let's say I use my potion of health. I treat this like a mailbox. I have these instant health potions in here because I was doing something, but I just stick in there. And then when I want to brew up some potions, I take it out and I come in here. I'm going to sleep real quick. Hopefully. Nope. And then I just put the water bottle up top. And this is an automatic brewing system, so I press the button and it gives me water bottles down here. I got a night vision potion. I have no idea how that happened. Oh, I think I got it off like a witch or something. I just stuck in there. Because I never put any golden carrots in there. So then I get instant health potions. I have to wait a minute for it to rebrew new ones, but then I press button, I get some more. This is just like, if I ever wanted to brew up some splash potions or potions that weren't instant health, like I keep gunpowder in there and that. There's a little balcony. And this is the first house. I saw this one in a tutorial. I added the balcony. Like, I kind of didn't watch the whole thing, but I watched enough to get the gist of how the house was laid out. And that's how the rest of my houses are built after this point. Have this, like, cobble on the bottom, logs as if they were supporting, glass, and wool. One sec. Sorry about that. I had to go. It's been a couple hours, so I think I remember what we were doing, but forgive me if I repeat something. Okay, so I think we're going downstairs, right? You sleep here. So I showed you the smelting area and the brewing stands and the automatic can't get up here. Brewing station, yep. I think I did that all. This is the first house. I just got a tutorial. This is kind of where I got the design for everything. From like the windows, the idea of having little things like this. Don't sneak up on me while I'm trying to record. You may notice my FOV, my field of zoom, has changed. I zoomed in because I remembered that most people play like this. I don't know if I said so, but I normally play with it on really far. So right now I feel a little bit like I'm looking through binoculars. So forgive me if my aim's off or something. So this obviously there was wheat here, but that's dried up. So there's two doors to this one. This lower one will come out there, but I'll show you the top one. This was probably, I think, the second one I built. So again, you can see that it doesn't follow the format of this house, having the wall having it come out or more support beams. So that's my attempt before I got my style down, at least for this area. I did know you're supposed to have windows. That's about it. So this is my AFK fishing area. It's a little dock, so you can kind of sit down. That area there was originally like an underground. There was kind of like a hill over it. So I dug that out, and then I dug this out. I dug out into this, made this pond, and dug out the river down to there. I also have this dock here, and just goes out into the lake. Nothing special. It's like a buoy. This tripwire there you may notice that will come in a moment. So up here, oops, is my storage. So this is, I forget all these. This is like treasures, so all the saddles and name tags I got. This is just fishing line. I think I call this junk technically. All the stuff like that I get. This is the fish. Yeah. I think that's where I put enchanting books, but I just have moved them out. I haven't used this off recently because I haven't really needed to. This is a storage area for the horses, so I can bring them in here. And this is half slabs, so I don't hurt my head. Just stop that. I can walk in and out, but the horses can't. I had a creeper explosion here, so that's why it's a little tight. But it is supposed to be a little tight, but it's a little off. That's where I can keep some of my rods if I want to, like this melon. I don't think that was there. I think that's just because I had the only building blocks on me. You can see my rods are here. I don't have a lot of great ones right now. Kind of at the enchant to make them great. I haven't emptied this, but that comes out. So what you do is you stand here, you hold a fishing rod, and then because the you see when I shoot an arrow through it, it's gonna trip the tripwire and the door's gonna close. I have to get the arrow through it. I think it needs more time. So the door closed, so when the fishing rod's out, the little bobber thing is an entity, so it works just like the arrow closing the door, but it stays out longer. So door stays shut. When the fish comes and bites it, it goes down, the door opens, and I left click pulling on it, 'cause the whole time I'm clicking, but it doesn't trigger because the door's in the way. But when the door gets out of the way, I use my fishing rod. So I just put a weight on my mouse to help her. So the only thing is I have had a creeper blast, like I said, where creepers sit like right here, or I guess it would have to be kind of like right here, or maybe they swim down. I don't know how they do it, but somehow they manage to blow this area up. So that's the one downside of that. This would be like an apartment renting area. And a stair there. This is the exit that I was talking about. I do like this little exit. This was originally my chicken farm. I had like four chickens in here. Bed, just pretty simple. Pathway comes up and around. Nothing much here. I could add something. I haven't yet. But it goes around the back. This originally wasn't necessarily meant to be connected. We're gonna go out there next, just so you know. So then you go into this area. I'm going to come back to this. There's something more important to that. But these again, I was just experimenting with the roofs, so I did keep them. But you may notice like there's a hole in that one. But there's some like kind of weird shapes. I was just playing around with it. So this is the first house. I don't think there's really anything in the chest, but see it. This was a melon farm. So this was for my farms. So melons and pumpkins. Then we have over here, we have, I think this was wheat originally, but I changed it to carrots and potatoes because I need more of those, or because there's two lines of carrots. A lot of these I've moved to the farm area out that way, so I don't really use these, but it's nice to have extra fields if I ever need a larger income. This is nether wart. I don't do much brewing, but when I do, it gives me a big enough crop. Save me for a while. This is here so that the chickens can get out because they'll wander in and then they'll get stuck. So you see, I can't walk out at the jump. Sugar cane, again, pretty simple. In here. There's the stuff I was looking for. Have a little shelf up there. Anything? Nope. This is wheat, pretty simple. So then, like I said, this is what's important, is a little bit like a barn or something. But this was my mess farm area until I actually built the farms. This was going to be like a sciencey lab, but it's fallen out of use because I have the other ones, so I don't really use it. Hence, it's fallen out of use, so I haven't taken time to decorate it. But there's going to be two aisles, I only have one. And this is the sugarcane. There is what, one, two, three, four, five, six-ish layers, something like that. They're all exactly like this. They have the glowstone and the stone and the birch. The water's in between the two birch levels. Pretty simple, three high. You stand here, you run through it. Sugarcane. When you're done, you stick it in that chest. This one is only two levels. Wheat. Again, same thing. You run through, you stick the excess seeds in there. I think, yeah, stick the excess wheat in there. Usually, when I harvest them, though, I'm using it, so usually I just take the stuff. So it's kind of uncommon to actually have stuff in there. Originally, when I was building it, I had a lot more just from doing it. I keep a bed here because it always seems whenever I go up to be night. So, kind of cool trick with the fence. When I want to add detail to a light, but I don't really want to spend time, that's what I do. So, still going this way? Yeah. So I had a mini little, some trees here. It was a little barren. Little tree. There's a little park, or something. The torches always freak me out when I come across. I always think one of these buildings is on fire. Again, actually, I'll show you. So, pretty simple design. There's pistons on the other side of this. Mine carts. So that mine cart is part of this section. It is modulable. I'm not sure that's the right use of that word, but this is a torch tower. Uses repeaters, and when it fires, it shoots this, the pistons, which pop off pumpkins. I'm sorry, I didn't say that. Which go into the hoppers. You see the pistons up there, which go into hoppers over there, which goes into a hopper minecart. I'll show that off later in just a minute. So I can go down here. All exactly the same. The top one is melons, but all the bottom ones are pumpkins. It was broken, so and just the melon one was working. I think the bottom mine carts might despawn or something because they're so far away from me usually. This is now my chicken storage because I use the chicken eggs for a lot of clocks. So this is a pretty simple let's see. I think if I break this, there shouldn't be any water. Okay, over here. This is just a really simple clock. If something's in the dropper, it shoots it out like that. He pulses back with the repeater, pulses on that. It does stop things from going through here, so only like one goes at a time with the redstone, but it's not a big deal. Picks things up out of that. So if I throw some steak on the track, it should pick it up. And you can see I just got fired, and it goes out there. I'll show that next. So that happens with all of these. Can I still stand on here? I think at one point I could. All the way up, and you see, so they all fall down onto these hoppers. Same setup over here, with that clock. It's on that side now. This is a water stream, and it pushes it into an item elevator. This fires every 5 minutes. Yeah, this is an egg timer. That's what's happening. This is a dropper and a dispenser, so I gotta see if I can kill that chicken. Nope. Oh, it's a zombie. I thought it was a chicken. Oh, well, I'll have to get the lighting in there. I'll steal this torch. Pretty important this works. It gives me a lot of my emeralds. And this is a pulse runner, so it just makes it a second. So normally it's just on, but this makes it so it is on just for a second. I also compress the button to make it fire. See if there's any. Yeah, as you can see them falling down. I would go up there, but then I'd pick them up. But they fall down from the top. Is all the pumpkins and stuff getting picked up by the mine carts? Throw some eggs in there. We'll show you where that goes in a minute. This was my little living room space while I was in here, building. So up we go. Yeah, so I had an iron farm. I moved it. It used to be in this area. That's how I got all my iron. And then everything else was just mining, pretty much. Almost nighttime, so I can show off this next house. Over here. So this is the house. This is based on that house over there. I think this is like the second house that I made that I was really satisfied with how it looked. This is a pumpkin house. The chimney is not functional, but it does have a function. I'll try to say that word. What it does is it is the item elevator. They get pushed into a hopper, which goes into here, and then you get funneled down. I have three chest storage. This is all that stuff that I threw in there. But it just gets all the stuff, and the melons don't pop that way. I've rebuilt them with the stuff. And then like extra building supply I keep in there. Crafting table, this is the main one, like I said. Upstairs, just a little facade, nothing realistic, but does have a bed. I have AFK in this house a lot because it keeps me near the pumpkins. So go out. So then the next house is this one. This is the dreaded library that I probably said talked about. Grab that one here real quick. And there's more. See if I can get that guy. Yep. Oh, he didn't die. And just for fun. I got cocky. See if I can get him. Come on. Yeah, there it goes. Okay. So this is the dreaded library. Pretty bad. I wanted like a tower, but I had no idea how to do that. So this is the dreaded library. It actually is pretty nice on the inside. Some lapis and other building supplies again. All these chests are single chests and tri used during using regular and tripwire chests, trap chests. So somewhere in here there should be a trap chest. This shouldn't not. Maybe it doesn't say trap chest. I thought it did. But I keep stuff in here. These are some of my picks from enchanting and combining. If I have like a pick that's almost dead and it has like efficiency 4, I'll keep it here so that when I have a couple, I can combine them and get efficiency 5. This was my first enchanting table with anvils. I put them in here. That one sideways. Actually, kind of nice view. You can see out in the distance. I think that's a crafting table. Yep. It's a nice little trick if you have like a wooden ceiling or a wooden floor, put a crafting table. Sometimes it looks funny in texture packs, but it looks pretty nice. So that's this area. Just to show you the iron farm that I moved, that I may show in this video or the next, depending on time, was over here. I built it, I completely got rid of everything. The villagers should still be alive, they're down here. Sky only has two. I think the other one has a lot more. I only had two compartments instead of the multiple. Usually, I think it's four. How did I then not hit you? I was kind of curious if it would work, and it looks like it did. So, the ones I have now only have one holding area, and one of them works, and one of them is just funky, and I don't understand it. So, that's it for this village. I wish I knew where my horse was. It'd be a lot quicker to get over there. I'll stick these in here real quick. And see, they'll go down, they'll come out down here. Yeah, I'll just throw these. I haven't used this in a while. And they're not getting caught up in the water stream. Come on. Show that this worked at one point. Yep, there it goes. That's it. Yep. So, we're going this way. So, just so you know, I wouldn't suggest really doing that for large dis areas because a lot of entities. When these are on the floor like that, they're entities. They can cause lag, so if you have like a farm or something, don't do that. Throw them into lava so they get destroyed if you want to get rid of them. So, just over this mountain, again, I want to connect this by road. I also want to connect it by river because I'll explain that in a minute. This is the library. Now, I will warn you before I look at it too much. The outside is disconjointed. I like the inside, I like the individual build styles, but I haven't found a way to mold them together. So, with that warning, that's the building. Especially the front with the columns. I really want columns, but it doesn't really match the rest, so I have to figure out what to do. It also looks a little barny, so I'm thinking about, like a barn, not like the show. I'm also thinking about, like, adding quartz or something, make it look a little more Romany. This river connects up with the farm, and I think we'll use that next to travel. So, like I said, it looks pretty bad on the outside if you look at it together, but individually it's pretty nice. So you come in. This is like the lobby or the waiting room. Fish tank. Kind of like it. There's no actual water, but it kind of looks nice. Little library area, sitting area. I tried this. I think it looks pretty bad, but I'd seen it around. I want to try out something new. Some ivy. We'll go out there next after this, before the river. This is a nice reading area. It's like a painting or something. It's really weird, I know. Tables. Again, a window looking out there. You have some nice shelving, and the ladder is. Like, it's supposed to be actually like you can get up here, but using that ladder, you can climb around here, which you're not necessarily supposed to be able to do. You can see the top of that roof is just flat, it's not how it's supposed to be. Let's see if I can hit that ladder. Anything above me? No. Whee! Did it. Not really supposed to be able to get up there, but you can. It's Minecraft, it's okay. So then, this is kind of one of my favorite things, is building these little balconies. You'll notice them a lot in my builds, because I like the feeling of having, like, an area where you can look down. But then a little reading room. There's an anvil in here. A nice little reading room, just to read. Not to put too fine a point on it. In fairness, this is the room that I did the outro in the last video. Ice for no reason at all. It needs something. It was blank, and I thought it looked cool. I kind of like the blue with these colors. You also see me use these colors a lot. I like them. The brewing stand, the nether warts, the books, cobble, and leaves. I like that. There's a lot of people have problems with using too much brick because it looks really nice and it's a good block for Minecraft. So I find by adding these vegetation colors, these bright colors, it goes nicely with the brick and it helps liven it up and give it different. Like you can use nether brick, like it really works well. So if you have a problem with using too much stone, just try adding some like leaves or something and your style will build on eventually. Ender chest. This is usable. I use it to cook up bricks or small stuff. This is my enchanting table that I use for now, because it's closer to my library, which is down there. That light is on, but that's because it's becoming night. It's not real close. Like if it's actually nighttime, it's on, but it has a little overlap. So this is the area that I called classified in my last video. It's not too amazing, but it's pretty big, and I liked the look. I extremely miscalculated, I don't know how many of these sections I would need, so I actually have extra. These are gonna go eventually, they're just my storage while I was building this, and I still kind of am. Where are you? There you are. Like, there's dark spots in here, like that, and this area isn't finished. This is so I can shuttle villagers, and this just picks up all the stuff that gets trapped in the flow, so I can pick up villagers, from the other side. Eventually, I'm going to add something there, but I don't know what yet. So, what you do here is I'm going to do for, let's say I wanted to put unbreaking, I think I've been breaking on everything, but let's say I want to put unbreaking on something. So, I'd go over to silicon efficiency, I think it's over here, unbreaking. Quick tip, never hold a weapon while you're talking to a villager. Usually doesn't end well. So I'd find the book. Well, in this case, it's the first one, but sometimes it might be the third or whatever. I could buy it. Or the other way I could get that book is if I have that book already. Remember that one? It's on this side. And now I have signs. Originally, I didn't. I kind of forgot about that. But I would look. Oh, I already have those books. So I don't necessarily need to buy it. So this is where I put them if I get them from like chests or fishing. This is level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, and level 5. For things they don't have, like Unbreaking doesn't have level 4, right? This is the best pick you can get. Nope. And so it doesn't have level 5 by default. I can use those for overflow, but pretty much just for decoration. Because if I really need overflow, I'd probably go back a block and put chests in. So I have that for all of these. I have these for all the enchants. And then down here it is. So these are pants. I kind of name them as I seem fit. Loathly, I think, yeah, it's like leather pants. I don't think I have any shoes or shirts or hats. These again aren't being used because it's not necessary. I have nothing on that side. Down here, I have I think I have more shovels and pickaxes and such. Oh, there's iron pickaxes. That's what I get from trading. Sometimes I'll get that. Diamond pickaxes. Fortune. Oh, that's a very nice pick. Work picks, like efficiency and silk. Shovels, you get the idea. Bows. My bows is probably the most interesting one. I have lowly bows. I get a lot from fishing, as I already said. These are pretty good bows. Like, I might use them to combine. These are bows with infinity, and these are bows with flame. And you can probably see, I don't see any overlaps right now, but there are overlaps between the two. I just have to choose which one I think is more important for that time period if I need more infinity bows versus more flame bows, depending on what I'm building, that kind of stuff. That side, I need something for over there. If you have any suggestions, leave that in the comments. I'm thinking like a mural, but I could pretty much do whatever. I have a lot of resources, even if you want to do like a redstone thing, as long as it's not too laggy. I'll take all the suggestions you give me and see what I can figure out. So, like I already said, we're gonna go out front. And over here. And this is the nice little area. There's a jack-o'-lantern, I think it's this one. String, that's how I make it not grow. Waterfall doesn't actually come from anywhere. Ivy, a nice little seating. And it's a nice little area. So this river, I think I said this, but oops, ow. Connects up with the other river that was forested. I used as my deforestation to get a lot of wood. And I'm really using it. I want to make this area a village eventually. Right now, I just have that. That is there because to remind me that I probably want to build a lighthouse. Yeah, I couldn't think of it. There eventually. I don't have one there yet, as you can see. This does connect, doesn't it? It should. I've boated it, so it wouldn't make a lot of sense if it didn't. How does this? Oh, it wraps around here. Okay, good. I was thinking. That has to connect. I was thinking it connected through here. But wraps around. We're gonna go over there. So horse stables. Again, I will warn you. That's that house. That the horse stables are not my best build, especially the outside. So we'll run right over there. So it may be enough time after this. I think I'll show the spooky house and then I think I'll wrap it up. I don't think I'll have enough time to show you the other thing. That'll be in a future video. Again, I think I said in the beginning it has been a few hours. I'm sorry that I'm so late. I got wrapped up in school. So, you go in here. You have horses. The ones with saddles are the average, are the best of jumping and running. So, might be better jumping or better at running, but they're good at both. Versus horses that are really slow but good at running, that kind of thing. Eat 'em. Nope. So these two horses are like that. I think it's this one that's good at running, and this one that's good at jumping or something like that. Jeesh. I spent a lot of time in here, so the difficulty might have gone up a little bit. Might be why. So I have that. I use this building here as a jumping area. You could see I didn't do it intentionally, but I have one and a half. They can't jump one and a half, they're not worth it. I just kill them on spot, unless they're amazing runners or something. I have three blocks here. Again, one, two, and then this is three and a half. They can jump that. They're good enough. I don't need to figure out exactly how high they jump. And then over here is a running track. I'm just gonna do it with myself versus getting a set horse. But I saw this and I thought it was pretty cool, so I made it here. I kind of made it off on the side because it's bad looking, but you saw I can run at a sprint speed of 3. Give it a minute. If I just walk, I got 2. I think most horses get around a 5 to a 4, 6 to a 4. 4 being a not great, 6 being pretty good, and 5 being normal. Anything past 7 seems to be pretty rare. I'm not sure if I have any horses there. So yeah, I mean, like I said, the building design on this is pretty bad. These control the downstairs lights. This was originally supposed to be like the inn, but I forgot about it. I'm kind of glad I did, 'cause this looks pretty bad. So we're gonna go over to the spooky house over there. And I'll be right back because this video is getting long, so I'm gonna cut out me walking. So be right back. Okay, so we're back. That's the spooky house up here. So there's not actually a good way to get to it. You have to jump over the fence. You can see there's holes in the wall. Some of this wool's discolored from the age of it. The roof is starting to sag. It's falling in. Just overall not a very good house. I tried adding some like lighting to it to make it look like it was dimly lit. But in contrast to these big lights, not big, but bright lights, you can't really see it. So it's kind of unfortunate, but that's what I did. Beware, keep out. You can probably get the gist. So we're gonna go in. Ready? Boo! Okay. I hope I got you with that. This guy was originally up above, like I'm from a video that BOOO made. And he glitched through the floor landing here, scaring me like crazy the first 3 or 4 times I walked through the door and kept forgetting that he was there. Really good way to scare yourself, have something glitch, and not know it's there. Again, materials that were left over, they have to move those. Upstairs doesn't have much in it. This is the wall behind it. It's supposed to be where that guy is, but he was right here, so, and now I just knocked the torch off. But glitch through. That was an awesome trick, Minecraft. Good job. Chests. These are just for extra storage when I come through, because this is my nether portal. If I need extra storage for storage, I can just stick it there. These are traps, so if any pigmen spawn. Sorry, I hit the mic. If any pigmen spawn, they think it's a full block like that, so they try to walk from one to the other, but because they're up or down, they just kind of fall off into the water stream. I've done that several times. So, down here, oh, I have a hole in here. I was trying to get some dogs out. I brought them to the nether? No, that doesn't sound right. Well, for whatever reason, they're down here. So, press this button, just crusher. They land on slime blocks, so they don't take any damage, and this crushes them down to half a heart to a heart. I can even use their own swords to kill them. So, if when I AFK in there, I would assume that has to do with something. I AFK on top of the nether, so I assume it has to do something with that, because there's not a lot of pigmen, it spawns a lot, but I don't know. But for whatever reason, I get a ton down there, so I decided to make a killer out of them. Close those real quick, and go through the nether. I'm gonna give it a minute. My recording software has given me trouble, so let me just check and make sure. Okay, it looks like it's working. That was probably pretty stupid, but I had it where I, like, took 5 minutes and then realized I wasn't recording. So, just wanted to make sure. So outside, I actually broke it. Oh, I fixed it. Oh. But you have smoke coming up. I thought that was pretty cool. A guest flew and hit, and then there was smoke when I covered it. I was like, oh, that's cool. So I did with the rest of them. So what you do is you go around back. There's a ladder. I think it's that way into the left a little bit. There's a nether fortress. So you go up here, and really long tunnel. So I'm coming back. We're right about, this is about the, it's not actually that far, it's just kind of far to talk. It'd get pretty boring. We're in the actual nether ceiling, and there's the bedrock. If you didn't know, there's like bedrock at the top of the nether, and then it kind of like comes down in these angles, and a lot of people use enderpearls. That is expensive, but you also kind of iffy. It's a little bit harder. There's this really simple trick with a minecart. There's a ladder above it. You just sit in the minecart. You can kind of see the situation. It has to look kind of like this. And you press shift. And you press walk and jump at the same time. Or wrong shift. I switched my shift. And you just kind of pop out. And I didn't take any damage because my armor, I think it normally takes about half heart of damage. But that's a really good way to get on top of the nether. And it's reliable and you can do it over and over. So you don't have to worry about wasting all your enderpearls. The storage chest, again, downstairs. Ender chest. This is for pumpkins. Obviously, it's really slow. But I only need a few. I threw gold swords down here last time. Or, next, there's one on top of that tree. So it may just be they fell off. Some trees to get wood. Nether portal, pretty simple. Always put a torch over your area so you know not to build there and suffocate when you try to come up. Yeah, keep enderpearls in here, so that when I was building, if I needed to, I could have a fall safe. Shoot one off right before I land, and try not to I keep hitting the mic. Try not to die. So, this is my pigment farm. You can see the guest legs over there, I think. Yep, that's what those are. Hopefully it's working. I haven't been here in a little bit, but this is where I got all that gold from, the first video to make that notch apple. If you haven't seen that, I suggest that you go look. It was kind of fun. So this level down here that I'm gonna go on doesn't actually have anything in it. This is overflow storage. If the top storage ever got full on gold or zombie flesh, I'd put it down here. I haven't AFK'd that long in a while. I accidentally left it on while I went on vacation. Yeah, and they got like tons of stuff. It was amazing. So rotten zombie flesh, gas tears, mega cream, gold nuggets, gold bars or ingots, gunpowder and iron ingots. And then this is all the swords and excess random stuff. There's some of the notch apples, apples I've made in the past. From the items in that chest, you might be able to figure out how this works. Well, I guess you've seen the iron golems. So this is just the pretty simple redstone. There's some sorters, and then this stuff, if I can get up here, is if there's excess in this hopper, I guess it is. Yeah, it shoots off the dispenser, and then it has stuff flowing into here. So if all these chests fill up, then when it gets to that one, it'll start chewing the stuff off until that one's empty. It's a pretty cool design. Half slab, so nothing spawns here. Real quick. There are some pigmen that spawn. I want to make sure I'm not going to hit a minecart and send it backwards. Stand back. Some pigmen that spawn, so it's not completely spawn proof, but I tried to spawn proof the little staircase. I had to have it go under because the way I built it. But I have two minecarts. And then they feed into this one system, one coming from that direction, one coming from the other direction. So up we go. A villager, I got him trapped in the portal, and then I kind of was just playing around with getting him up here, and somehow I managed to get him up here. So he's up here. It's kind of curious if he would do anything but the iron golems, but doesn't really look like he does. Top of the ceiling, I'll do target practice on this from up there if I'm bored. That's the spawning platform. I'll try to hit that. And I can't hit him now. Come on. I gotta show off my bow skills to the new viewers. Like, 0.5 of you. So originally, first comes through here, so if I have extra, I can just stick in there. And then it goes through the sorting system. This is a bunch of iron golems. I just made tons, so I don't have to worry about their lifespan. Oops. Forgot if I go in here, the guy gets mad. But they kill the zombie pigmen sometimes. Right now they're kind of like separated. Let's see if we can get one over here. Come on. Yep, there he goes. So he kills them, and they don't get mad at me, as you can see. I get a lot of XP from this. I don't know why I'm losing hunger all of a sudden. But I think that guy just died. So they do die. They take some damage from the pigmen, and they're not smart enough to walk away from fire. But I can get a good amount of XP from this if I leave it running for like half an hour and come down. All the drops get picked up by the hoppers below. It's pretty simple. Oops, I almost stick out there. It'd be bad. So go out here. Up. Ain't nothing special, but that's up there. I just wait for them to spawn, and then they fall down and sort stuff and do stuff. So, be right back. Hey, so I'm back, guys. You didn't really think I'd leave you without a spoiler. Sorry, wrong word. For now, I'm just looking over here. You might be able to notice a few things right now. But stay tuned, and I'll be coming out with a new video in a little bit. Sorry this one was late. Hope you had fun. Leave any suggestions or anything you want to say in the comments, and I hope both of you will be right back with the next video. Bye!